So, yesterday I have told about some topics which are very, very important related to IoT. Now, today I am going to teach the IoT in the form of Python programming, and I will tell some concepts regarding that so that you will get a clear-cut idea that how we are using Python programming on the basis of IoT. So I am going to explain with the help of one example, the blinking of LED. As you all know that the LED blinking you have seen in embedded C programming, right? But today I am going to explain the same programming in the form of Python. So let us see how it actually works. I am going to explain each and every line perfectly. The program I am writing, LED blinking program using Python. So it's very, very easy Python.
After 5 minutes, 5 minutes.
Pura sir, pura nikal diye
sir. Okay.
So the program I have written here is completely a Python programming. See how many lines it is taking. Generally it is taking I think 7 to 8 lines only. Within the 7 to 8 lines I have completed my LED blinking program. Before explaining this program, I want to discuss some basic points regarding Raspberry Pi. Okay, so why Raspberry Pi we are using? It is a mini computer. Raspberry Pi is a mini computer which will act as a normal desktop computer only, but it is very mini in size, like a credit card, right? So using Raspberry Pi we can do automation projects, at the same time we can work it like a monitor, and anyway we can use the Raspberry Pi, and it is very much comfortable with respect to IoT devices. Why? Because its size is very less and efficient in working in comparison to all other processors and controllers. So Raspberry Pi, there are many versions of Raspberry Pi, 2 is there, 3 is there, so many versions are there, but in our subject I am using Raspberry Pi 2.7 model. So Raspberry Pi 2.7 model, how many things will be there, what are the blocks, what are the modules which are present in the Raspberry Pi? So first of all, coming to the USB 2.0, okay, USB ports 2.0 version I am using here. USB port we can use for storage purpose, at the same time for connecting anything, right, like pen drive, SD card and everything, right? And at the same time USB port is useful for connecting Wi-Fi adapter also. Why? Because in the name itself it is given, Internet of Things. So what do you mean by Internet of Things? All the embedded things and non-embedded things which are connected in a network through the internet. So that is the meaning of Internet of Things. I have discussed in the earlier class also. Now coming back to Raspberry Pi, here HDMI cable, by using HDMI cable I can run my monitor, I can run my television also using Raspberry Pi. So only HDMI cable is needed to connect the Raspberry Pi with my monitor or with my TV. It is a requirement, it depends upon our requirement. It is not necessary that we should work Raspberry Pi like that only. It completely depends upon our requirement. So it is according to our wish. And the another additional feature what it is having means two things are there here, CSI and DSI, camera interface and digital interface. So what is camera interface and digital interface? See, for getting the output we should see somewhere, right? For that we require LCD panel or LED panel we require. So LCD panel can be connected to DSI port, and CSI means camera. So Raspberry Pi, one more additional feature is that we can use it as a camera also. If we require to use Raspberry Pi as a camera, like a camera, we can use like a camera by using this port, CSI port, camera serial interface port, right? Okay, so these are some additional points what I felt that I should discuss before going into this program. Okay, now coming to the program, it is very very easy. So what is import? What is import? Import means taking something, right? Import RPI, Raspberry Pi. Okay, GPIO, what do you mean by GPIO? GPIO means general purpose input output. Okay, general purpose input output. Okay, what is the meaning of general purpose input output? Means normal ports. Okay, so here total 26 pins are there, in which 18 pins are used for GPIO purpose, general purpose input output interface port is there. Here total we are using 18 pins, and the remaining pins are used as a ground, power supply and all the other specialized operations, right? So at the next class I am going to discuss what it actually means. So till here it is very clear that how many general purpose input output pins it's having, right? Okay, so let us go to the programming. It will be very very interesting. Import Raspberry Pi GPIO as GPIO means I am giving instruction to the Raspberry Pi that I want to use GPIO, general purpose input output port. My Raspberry should function as general purpose input output port. I am giving an instruction to the Raspberry Pi, right? This is the first line is I am giving instruction, and second line I am importing time. I want to import some time. Why? Because LED blinking, blinking means what? Sometimes off, sometimes on, sometimes off, sometimes on, depending upon the time period what I am giving here, right? Okay, so for that I want to import time also, and this is also I am giving instruction to my Raspberry Pi through programming using Python program, right? Now setup, GPIO setup, this is the third line. What do you mean by that? Means here total 18 pins are there, GPIO general purpose input output pins are total 18 pins. In that I am using the last pin, 18th pin, for blinking my LED auto on or to off. So 18th pin is my last pin I am using for connecting LED and making LED to blink. Okay, so this is the output pin. I am using this pin as a output pin, right? 18th pin, I am using this pin as a output pin for blinking my LED. So this is the third instruction what I am going to give. And the next one is the main program. The main program. You would be surprising that sir, why you have given this while loop. See, in embedded C also for blinking the LED, we will give the perfect timing, right? 1 minute, 2 minute, whatever delay we want to give, we will give. And here also I am giving some delay, right? According to that delay only, why I am giving while loop? For the continuous operations, right? Until and unless I will interrupt, that LED must blink off and blink on continuously, okay? Without any human interruption and without any disturbances, right? So that's why I am giving for continuous working, I am giving this while loop as a true condition I am giving, right? So here again GPIO dot output, I have discussed here, I have told that GPIO pin, 18th pin I am using as an output pin. So I have given the same line here only. And the 18th pin true. True means what? Logic. Logic 1. Okay. True means what? Logic 1. That means my LED will blink. My LED will blink. Okay. My LED will blink. Where I will get my LED output? 18th pin I will get my LED output. Right. Now time dot sleep. Okay, time dot sleep. I have told you now that I am giving some delay. So that delay I am giving in the form of sleep. Okay, now sleep parameter I am using here, and I am giving some delay, and it should be infinite. Okay, infinite delay. Okay, so I am giving that delay. So according to that delay, whatever it may be, 1 minute, 2 minute, 3 minute, whatever timing I have given, it will take. It is a general delay I am giving generally, but in real time we will give some time, whether 1 minute, a half minute, or 3 minutes, or 4 minutes. So it is a general programming. That's why I have not selected any particular time, right? But you can understand that normally for blinking LED, how much we want? 1 minute we can take, half minute we can take. So let us take. I am taking half minute sleep time. I am taking. So till half minute, till my completion of half minute, my LED will continuously blink. It will be on, logic 1 true on. Okay, then again next what I will do, again what should I write? My LED means blinking. Now I should make my LED blink. Blink means sometimes off, sometimes on. It is completely on for half minute. Okay, it is completely on for 20 seconds. Now what I will do, again I will give an instruction to make my LED off. Okay, see, 18th pin, same GPIO as an output. Which pin I am using as an output? 18th pin I am using as my output, and false. So false means automatically the reverse of logic 1, means logic 0, false. False means off. My LED will be switched off after the completion of 30 seconds. Again I am giving sleep time. Again I am giving sleep time. Again I am giving 30 seconds delay. Again after the 30 seconds delay, my while loop will run continuously. It is an infinite loop. Again my LED will be on, 30 seconds delay, off, 30 seconds delay, on, off, on, off, on, off, on, off. So in this way I am making my LED to blink completely on or completely off for 30 seconds delay. So this is the Python programming. What is the advantage of using Python programming in IoT? See, first of all, what we have observed, it has a broadband library. It has a broadband library. Okay, it has a broadband library. So many library instruments will be there which are not present in the embedded C or everything, right? So here inbuilt broadband library will be there. So many interfaces we can do, so many objects we can run. So it is very, very important, broadband library. And the second benefit is easy to understand. Okay, easy to understand. See, in the program itself I have told you, in the program itself I have told you easy to understand. Why I have written this point? See, very, very easy to understand. So what I have done, only timing parameter I have given. I have given to input and output. 18th pin I have selected as an output, and I have completely written this program using English language only. Similar to the English language only. So it is very easy to understand, easy to write, easy to write. Easy to write, okay, less lines it is consuming, the fourth one. And the fifth one is scalability. Scalability. Scalability means, here not only Python we can write, we can use some C language, C++ language, low level modules also in that. So scalability means what? Any programming we can use inside the Python. So it has some scalability. Extendability. And the next one is extendability. 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 Okay. Extendability means it can be extended to any of the processor and controller wherever we want. Okay. It can be extended to any other processor and controller. So no restrictions will be there, as we have seen in the embedded C programming, right? So that is the point. And the last but the not least is, it is a interpretable language. It is a interpretable language. Okay, it is an interpretable language. What do you mean by interpretable? Interpreting means what? Converting from one form to other form. Okay, Interpretable means in other languages, what we have seen, it may be C, Java and everything, there the source code will not be directly converted into the meaningful language. But here, what I am doing, only I am giving some instructions in the command prompt, and whatever instruction I am giving, within the fraction of seconds I am getting the output. Okay, Amma? So, thank you so much for...
No, stop. Yeah, center.
Yes.